Metroidvania has had a knight as a king on the throne, with Hollow Knight setting the bars for others to follow really high for the last couple of years. With Ender Lilies, Quietus of the Knights, developer Adglobe and Livewire aims to take a stab at the king with a beautiful gothic anime blade. And it's easy to get swept away by the beautiful music and the sound of falling rain in this action RPG, as you summon the full force of the spirits upon enemies in an attempt to free them as you carefully navigate a nation destroyed by a cataclysmic event. But when you are done with the playthrough of this game, just entering early access, you will both feel frustrated and hungry for more. They say there is no light without dark, no good without evil, no right without the wrong, that nothing can exist if its direct opposite does not also exist. And as you take your first steps as Lily, the last surviving priestess, accompanied by a mysterious dark knight, your footsteps and the knight's blade is the only thing that breaks the veil of silence. And after the deathly rain suddenly started to fall over the Kingdom of End, transforming all living things it touched into bloodthirsty corpses, your task is to guide the young and pure heroine on a sorrowful path to unravel the mysteries of the fallen kingdom. Your first taste on this beautiful storytelling, a touch of sadness, comes as you meet your first blighted and defeat her. As Lily is suffering from memory loss, she doesn't remember that Guardian Sigrid protected Lily, but that the never-ending bloodshed caused her to be consumed by madness and turn into a monster. And it's from these encounters and glimpses of the past that you start to feel the battle Lily has before her when she has to battle old friends. But not all can be darkness, so as a light and a way to further aid you, a defeated blighted can be purified and saved, and they will then follow you on your journey. This giving you access to new and different skills, said to be around 26 on the game's final release. The different levels or rooms of the map are beautiful to watch, but deadly to stay too long to admire, since most of the enemies can easily mean the end of Lily in just two hits. Ender Lilies will challenge you with the tense boss battles where the wavering focus or the slight misstep easily can lead to untimely death. And as the boss enters its second stage, armed with new movesets and attack patterns, and you frantically almost press every button on the controller just to survive, it's also then you feel that rush of excitement and glory if you come out victorious of this encounter. Fans of John Woo slow motion style to tell an action story, you feel right at home with the finishing blow to a boss. There is no linear storytelling, and with an attempt to let the player have full freedom of what path to take and what bosses to fight, you can still expect some backtracking, since early on you will notice paths you cannot cross. It can range from bringing the heaviest spirit to crush the surface to something as simple as diving deep into the water. But what would a dark fantasy anime world be without a beautiful soundtrack? And here is another way for Ender Lilies to offer immersion and presence. Immersion comes from the beautiful background music that follows you along and heightens the contrast of the pure and vulnerable Lily, the dark-tainted knight, and the world around them. Presence comes from the sudden shift of music in battles to give you a hint of that it's now time to really focus. The soundtrack is created by Millie, whose credits include Goblin Slayer opening rightfully and Ghost in the Shell. And as you start to upgrade your skills and find your favorite spirits to play with, it's time to reach the end of this early access version. Ender Lilies, Quietus of the Knights enters early access in a genre largely dominated by Hollow Knight. It's a promising game that in its current form can offer you around 4 hours of gameplay to reach the sign telling you that the early access part is done. The attention to details in the game is on a really high level, from the small details like the fragile Lily cowering a bit when you unleash a big attack, to that your flying bird switches between following you and shooting at enemies behind you seamlessly. But the playthrough leaves me with more questions than answers, as there are points on the map I can't really yet access. Those could easily be hidden away to ease off the attempts to reach them and avoid frustration. But will the priestess knock the king off the throne? I say it remains to be seen when the final version comes out. I for one will follow the development of Ender Lilies with great excitement to see what awaits in the following month. But you know what? Let's not end this journey here. We have talked about the story, the awesome gameplay and the soundtrack, and also what you will get if you decide to buy this game and play it. So to give you the chance to experience even more amazing indie games, I have added another video that I think that you will love to the upcoming end screen. So I will see you there. Until next time, stay safe and stay awesome.